have something that I would like to say. Could you stop playing that before I heave this knife in your direction? Thank you. Young lady with the wine, would you mind just standing right by my side? I'll never leave, because I have much to say and many to toast. Those of you who do not know, my name is Richard Brown, professor of English.
Cheers to me.
Cheers.
To Richard.
Henry Wright, on behalf of every one of us here, let me please express our gratitude for this finely forced evening. The commitment that you have shown to the students, faculty, even the wives of the faculty. It's very, very impressive. You've outdone yourself. And it shows. As far as I'm concerned, three balls deserves three cheers.
No. All right, Richard, I think that's enough.
Henry, do not interrupt me while I'm talking, particularly in front of so many people. Do you understand?
No, I don't understand.
Yeah. Nobody. To Peter Matthew.
Oh, oh, got a shout out.
Your heart is truly one of gold.
It is.
And this college is very lucky to have you.
Well, that's true.
Of course, thank you for your hard work. But most important, thank you for being a true friend.
To Peter.
Cheers.
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 Also, there are some parting words that I feel like I owe. Because this will be the last time that I ever see any of you. For not only have I been awarded a sabbatical, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. And I'm gonna die much sooner than I imagined.
Oh, my goodness.
I know, dear.
What is he talking about?
So in preparing for what lies ahead, I've come to realize that for much of my life, I've been mistaken. And I failed. I failed not only to comprehend my mortality, but I failed to appreciate it. And as a result, I've failed to make the most of my life. Veronica, you're one hell of a sport. You are a very worthy adversary. Proud to have been able to call you my wife. Because life without you would have been far less rich. And for that, I thank you. What if it's worth? I love you deeply. We've turned our backs on the most important duty that we possess, to live a life that is rich in experience. It's of our own independent choosing. Seize your fucking existence, folks. Why don't we make death our closest fucking companion so that we can finally have a second, a millisecond to appreciate that little bit of time that we have left. And most important of all, let us live well so that we may fucking die well. Because we've never been so close to death. In this very moment.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Damn it, Richard, those are crystal.